still in Iran, and it's been more than 6 months from the death of 22-year-old Mahsa Amini in custody. Since then, hundreds of protesters have been killed and thousands arrested. The Islamic Republic has celebrated its National Day, while many people are still resisting.
These are faces amongst hundreds of others who fought for freedom but will not live to see it. Since September, the Islamic Republic of Iran saw the largest and most radical anti-regime protests in its 43-year history. It was sparked by the death of 22-year-old Mahsa Amini in the custody of the so-called morality police. Her crime? Not wearing her hijab properly. Life seems to have returned to normal, and around 22,000 demonstrators who were arrested have been pardoned.
People can't stay on the streets forever. The movement is far from over. Things are only getting started.
This is something that will take time, because it's also a cultural issue.
Mahmoud and Raha, their names have been changed to protect their identities, are in their 20s and have been taking action in the uprising.
The protests here have changed form. People are continuing the unrest through graffitis, burning street signs, taking down CCTV cameras and planning other forms of attack.
And the monitoring of the hijab has been tightened at universities.
We now have hijab security at the university's entrance. If we're showing too much hair, they don't allow us in. If we get a second warning, then we can get excluded from the university. But away from the security, we drop our headscarves.
Mahmoud risks torture, imprisonment and even death at the hands of the Islamic Republic for just speaking with me. But he's adamant to share his experience of the lethal crackdown in the hands of the regime during the protests.
One evening, the anti-protest police raided us. I was running away when I heard a motorbike behind me. Then he shot me.
Mahmoud avoided arrest, but was left seriously wounded. Footage given exclusively to Sky News reveals the extent of his injuries. He'd been hit by pellets from a gun.
I had around 250 pellets inside me. After 4 hours on the operating table, medics only managed to pull out around 30.
Mahmoud was told that the rest would have to remain in his body, meaning he's unable to leave the country.
I now constantly live in fear of being identified in case someone sees my scars. I cannot go through any metal detecting gates because the metal left in my body could identify me as a protester. I would be looking at anything between years of imprisonment to even execution.
But Raha and Mahmoud aren't deterred.
You can't keep scaring people forever. There is only one way forward, and that's a revolution.
When we know the law protects us instead of oppressing us, then we will have the freedom to claim our rights.
Street demonstrations may have eased for now, but daring displays of public defiance remain. And as the regime desperately tries to conceal traces of their disobedience, the protesters persist. The regime must go. Sahar Zand, Sky News.